A borrowed tomb, but on Sunday morning he would rise again. Today we will tell his story through music and scripture. We pray that by the end of our presentation you will see Sunday morning in a completely new light. And now I present the Reid Chapel Concert Community Choir and Orchestra Ensemble with Come Sunday Morning, under the direction of Miss Trafina and Rue Taylor. Thank you. today. Come by here, Lord. It's a spiritual that picks the cries of our people. This arrangement is composed by an African-American, Dr. Uzi Brown, who's a native of Calpin, South Carolina. The song will be followed by the scripture through dance. The Bible says, from the lips of children and infants, you have established praise. Miss Siler Laurie, a fourth grader at Greenview Elementary School, will dance to I Shall Not Want, a song based on Psalm 23.
I shall not run. I shall not run.
God's a good God. We stand in adversity. He makes things happen. It's the Jesus is the reason for the season. This baby worked that thing out. Yes, she did. God bless us. We praise him for who he is and what he has done and for what he will do in our lives. At this time, Miss Taylor will that name, followed by the choir with Little Innocent Lamb.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord. The Bible says, at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and tongue confess that he is King of Kings and Lord of Lords. There is a name that is so precious, a name so wonderful to me, a name that's worthy of all praises. Because of him, I am made free. That name is Jesus. Oh, how I will have life eternally. His name speaks peace unto my storm clouds. His name speaks calm unto my fears. I know when I feel that no one loves me, his loving presence is so near. That name is Jesus. Oh, how I love him, the one who gave his life for me. Because of love so unconditional, I will have life eternally.
lamb, little lamb, little innocent lamb.
Innocent lamb.
I'm gonna serve God till I die.
Hypocrite, hypocrite,
tell you what you do.
I'm gonna serve God till I die.
He'll talk about me and he'll talk about you.
Talk about you.
I'm gonna serve God till I die.
Little lamb, little lamb, little innocent lamb.
I'm gonna serve God till I die.
Little lamb, little innocent lamb.
Innocent lamb.
I'm gonna serve God till I die.
Devil, he's on a slippery shoe.
I'm gonna serve God till I die.
Now if you don't mind, he's gonna slip it on you.
Slip it on you.
I'm gonna serve God till I die.
Cause there ain't no dying over
there. There ain't no dying over
me. In that family, in that
family.
In that family, in that family. In that family, in that
family. In that family. Little innocent lamb,
innocent lamb.
I'm gonna serve God till I die.
Cause there ain't no dying over
there. There ain't no dying over
in that heavenly land. In that heavenly land. In that heavenly land.
For the past few years, we've had the privilege of presenting scholarships to students who will major in the arts. Tonight, our recipient is Parker Jones. Please welcome Parker as he brings the beats.
Thank you. good.
Yeah.
How awesome is that? So Buddy Rich, Doc Severinsen, and Dorian Hollis, they don't have anything on you, Parker. Mr. Parker Jones is the son of Miss Santel Davis and Mr. Parker Jones. He attends Fairfield Central High School in Winnsboro, South Carolina. At Fairfield Central, Parker maintains a 3.1 GPA. He's a member of chorus, marching band, and other ensembles. His band director is Mr. Timothy Bryant, and his chorus instructor is Reverend Byron Dixon. Parker has received several awards. He's the band section leader. He's been named most reliable and most outgoing. I can understand that. In the letter of recommendation from his chorus instructor, he is praised for having a love for learning and a commitment necessary to succeed in college and beyond in the music arena. Parker is well respected and always keeps a smile on his face. Music makes him happy. Around music, he lights up like a little boy.
Amen.
He accepts the challenges of music, such as music theory, sight singing, ear training, oral skills, and more. Although he's played other instruments, the drum is his instrument of choice. He's always beating on something, so his professor says. He's been beating on books, tables, and chairs, whatever's in his reach becomes his drum. Parker has been accepted to Alabama State University, where he will study music performance. So now, thank you for this great performance tonight. On behalf of Reverend Carey A. Grady, Mr. Fila Ann Taylor, and the Reid Chapel AME Community Concert Choir, it gives me great pleasure to present this scholarship to Parker Jones in the amount of $500. Parker.
At this time, we'll ask Reverend Grady to direct us with our worship in our gifts.
Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Let's all stand. Let's give the concert. Thank you. things come of thee, O Lord.
Seen and heard today, and think of how wonderful it is. And I want you to sit back and enjoy this next part here. And now, please journey with Jesus as he goes from Palm Sunday to Resurrection Sunday. He rides into Jerusalem on a borrowed donkey. A few days later, he has his last supper with his disciples in the upper room to give them his final instructions before he is betrayed by one of his own, convicted by the crowd, and led to Golgotha Hill. Can you believe it? As a parallel to life today in this political climate, the people choose Barabbas. He's a known criminal to be released from prison. All the good that Jesus had done did not make a difference. And now, the resurrection story.
Very well, very well.
There's a
Jesus! of the week began to dawn. Mary Magdalene, the other Mary, came to see the tomb. And looked at Jesus. But they found it gone. The tomb was empty. Then the angel told them, he is not here. He is risen. Just as he said. And now he's alive.
Thank you.
And now we'll do He's Alive, followed by Pastor Grady.
Alive!
Let's all stand. And because we can stand on his promises that he lives.
Amen.
Oh Lord, my. Because we can stand on his promises that he lives, we can make it today and tomorrow, next week, next month, next year. We can stand on the promises that God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. We can stand on the promises that God is our creator, Jesus is our redeemer, and the Holy Spirit is our comforter. And all Jesus wants with all of us is a relationship. Somebody say relationship.
Relationship.
We would be remiss on this Palm Sunday in an Easter concert not to extend the invitation to a brand new life. All eyes closed, all heads bowed. We thank God for this community concert choir ministry. And we thank you for the one who they sing about, Jesus. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and tongue confess that he is King of Kings and Lord of Lords. There may be someone this evening, all eyes closed, all heads bowed. There may be someone this evening who has enjoyed every song that they've heard, but does not know Jesus for themselves. We invite you right now to formally and officially establish a relationship with him. All it takes is A, B, and C. Accept, believe, and confess. If you desire a relationship with the Lord Jesus, just simply raise your hand where you are. Amen. If you're already saved, just raise your right hand and say, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
It is often difficult for unbelievers to accept that Jesus is alive. Because naturally, when someone dies, they don't come back to life. Nobody in all of history has risen from the grave except for Jesus Christ. But we know that he is alive because he lives in us. Let's listen to the musical testimonies of Pierce Oaks, followed by Corey Boyce with, and he blessed my soul, and I'd rather have Jesus.
One look at Jesus.
I'd rather have Jesus. to them.
Devotion in bringing this musical experience to all the different communities here in Columbia, South Carolina. And we just want to thank her for all that she has done. Let's give her a hand as she comes with her.
Well, praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Yesterday at our dress rehearsal, I shared this scripture. It's one of my favorite scriptures. It's actually one I can say from memory. It's Philippians chapter 1, verse 6, and it starts off with this word. I am confident, and I love that word, confident, that he who has begun a good work in you will continue until the day of Jesus Christ. Yeah. And I just feel that the Lord has started this good work in us. As you've heard, this is our 18th performance, Easter concert. We only missed one, and that was in 2020 because of COVID. And so it wouldn't be possible to have these 18 years without you. Dedicated family members, and I know I have some family members here today. They want to wave their hand. It's all right. It's all right. And some friends and just some patrons. They always come to the rescue. They always come to the rescue. It is quite a pleasure to work with the choir members. And I really feel like Reverend Grady says, he's talking about, you know, we journey into the cross. And this is not just a feel-good choir or presentation, but hopefully that you will get closer to God. I hope that's our intention. Now, if you go home and say, I didn't hear nothing I liked, you telling a lie. Started to say a story. And the concert is designed like that. It's by design. It's by design, because we know we all are different and we all at different places in our walk with Jesus. And so we want to just, I want to give a shout out to some folk. And always my choir members will let me know if I've forgotten anybody. We believe in young people.
Yes.
Yes, we believe in our young people, so we want to thank them. We want to give a shout out to Parker Jones.
Yes.
Yes, he kept the beat. And I'm going to introduce our musicians, and then I'll let Miss Pat introduce her orchestra members. So, on organ, we have Pierce Oates. Pierce is going to be graduating soon from Claflin. That doesn't mean he's leaving us. He's just graduating, okay? You get that, Pierce? All right, Anita Aiken on keyboard. Okay. We have Mari. Mari, what's your last name?
Watson.
Mari Watson on drums. And Kerwin Hips on guitar. And of course, I have some special helpers. They just won't let me sit down, but and I appreciate it. Belinda Thomas. And I don't know if the Wilsons are here. Antona Wilson, Tony Wilson. If she's not, give her a big hand anyway. Okay. Did I leave out anybody? Corey, boys, Corey has been with us from the beginning, and she's so faithful.
Amen.
So, and I echo that sentiment of that song. I'd rather have Jesus, that's right, and anything this old world could offer. So now I'm gonna let, ask Pat to introduce her people, okay?
Thank you, Ms. Taylor, and good evening, everyone. This is the Reid, they like to call us the orchestra. You see, it's only seven people. So we are the Reid Chapel Chamber Orchestra, and it changes with each year, depending on what the music is. So today we have, who is always here, Mr. David Ezell. He is a keyboard, bass, clarinet, and he arranges all of the music. He arranged all of the music for the ensemble. We have Michael Reisman on violin and cello. We have Alejandro Salgado. He is on violin one. We have Benita Green, who is Miss Taylor's cousin. She is on bassoon and saxophone. And we have Mrs. Ezell on violin two. And we want to thank Mari for playing the drums with us. Wait a minute. Huh? Will you please? As you can see, and as has been stated, Reid Chapel loves its young people. And the orchestra, or the chamber orchestra, is no exception. We have a young lady with us who did not make her name onto the program. I didn't have her name at the time. I had to turn in the names. Her name is Abigail Michael. She's playing violin. Abigail is a freshman at the Richmond Northeast High School. She's been playing violin since she was 3 years old.
Wow.
11 years. And she started with Mrs. Ezell as her teacher. She and all of us here are members of the Columbia Community Orchestra, which Reid Chapel so graciously lets us call home. So we thank Reid Chapel for that. And we thank you for your support of the orchestra and of our chamber orchestra and this concert and the Christmas concerts, all of the concerts that we participate in. Thank you.
Of course, I forgot someone. Hi, How could I forget Reverend Byron Dixon? He's always there to help us. And before Reverend Grady comes before us, I want to invite you to our 20th Christmas concert. How about that? 20 years. How about that? So it's going to be December the 7th, I think. It's always the Saturday before the second Sunday. So we just invite you right now to tell your friends, tell your family to come and have a good time, okay? And always, I just appreciate, we all appreciate our pastor, Reverend Carey A. Grady, for his vision and working with the community and his love of music.
And at this time, we'll have a special presentation.
Sister Taylor.
Yes.
I love you. I would be remiss if I didn't make the time just to say thank you, Sister Taylor. Thank you for your vision. Thank you for the dreams that you dream at night when you come up with all the narration and the song selections that we do. And each year, I think it's the best. And then she outdoes herself again the next year. And there's no duplication. That's the blessed thing about it. Every year, we have something different, don't we?
That's right.
And every year, we are touched spiritually. And y'all might not know it, but this is a very special choir and orchestra unit here. It's a labor of love. Yes. It really is. And we're a family.
Yes.
We truly are. And so, we could never pay you for the work that you do, the sacrifices that you've made, and you didn't have to throw no shoe this year. Thank the Lord. And so we would like to present you with these orchids. And then I have a special invitation in this envelope that we will not open until after the concert. And we want all choir members to meet us in the Fellowship Center just for a few minutes when the concert is over. We love you, and we're really looking forward to the 20th, because I know you're already thinking about it and dreaming about it already.
I am.
Thank you so much, and we love you.
Closing song.
And now we'll have remarks and acknowledgments from Pastor Grady.
Let the church say amen. Go right into the closing song. Amen.
Amen.
Saturday night, Saturday, Saturday,
now.
I'm so excited. I'm so happy.
Over the Lord Jesus.
Over the Lord Jesus. Jesus love me.
Let's celebrate.
Let's celebrate.
The Lord.
Lord,
all stand. I would like those who are sitting in the congregation to repeat after me. Say thank you, choir members.
Thank you, choir members.
Thank you, orchestra.
Thank you, orchestra.
Thank you, musicians.
Thank you, musicians.
Thank you, Sister Taylor.
Thank you, Sister Taylor.
God loves you, and so do we. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Morning. May the Lord bless and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up the light and presence of his countenance upon you now and forever.